understand Christmas is just 1 week away. And let's come and rejoice, for the Christmas is a time for us to worship our God. Amen.
Amen.
Both here in Woodlands, in Tampines, and those of you at home, would you join us just like the angels were declaring of the coming of our Lord? Come on, let's worship Him this morning. Chapter 2, verse 11 to 14 says, today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you, and you will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger. Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly hosts appear with the angel, praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom His favor rests. And may the peace of God rest upon us during this Christmas season time, as we recognize that Jesus left His glorious throne to come to earth to be with us. Who would expect a little baby one day would have nails pierced through his hand, would have hung on that cross, the little one, but yet He came for that purpose. And the angels in heaven would cry out, glory, holy to His name. Let's worship Him today, shall we? Oh, we worship You, Lord. We sing praises to You, Emmanuel. And the angels cry, holy, all creation cries, holy, You are lifted high, holy, holy forever. Hear Your people sing.
Come on, let's sing.
You, the King of Kings,
holy,
as You will always be, holy, holy forever. You will always, You will always be, holy, holy forever. So we cry out, holy Lord, to You. Join with all the angels, day and night, from one end of the universe to the other side.
Thousand generations falling down in worship to sing the song of ages to the Lamb. And all who gone before us and all who will believe, sing a song of ages to the Lamb. 'Cause Your name is the highest, Your name is the greatest, Your name, it stands above them all. All thrones and dominions, all powers and positions, Your name, it stands above them all. And the angels cry, holy, all creation cries, holy, You are lifted high, holy, holy forever.
Now
To worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that
worship you today.
Here I am to worship.
Just like wise men and shepherd
king, presenting gifts to God.
The King of all things.
God of glory.
is the King of Kings. Let's give the Lord another round of applause. Hallelujah. Because Jesus Christ, He deserves all our praise and glory and our worship. Amen and amen. Dear brothers and sisters, take the seat in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. What a joy to gather together to give our best to the Lord. Welcome all. Good morning, everyone who are worshiping at Lighthouse Woodlands, our Tampines Center, and those worshiping online. God bless you. I'd like to particularly welcome everyone who are first time here, both on site and online. Anyone that's worshiping with us first time, I'd like to invite you to raise your hand so that we can identify you and give you the warmest welcome. Anyone at Woodlands? Tampines? God bless you. Praise the Lord. Now for family news. As we are celebrating Christmas during this season, while we are busy having this celebrating and eating and rejoicing, let us also remember why Jesus came on Christmas Day. He comes because He loves us, and He came to give Himself as the Savior of the world to die on the cross for you and me. So during this Christmas, let us remember our loved ones, close friends, who are yet stranger to the grace of God. We have Christmas tree at the lobby of LEW, at a car porch of LET, and we have prepared cards and markers whereby you can write down the name of those that you like to pray for, that the Lord's grace will touch them, so that they will know Jesus Christ as their personal Lord and Savior as well. So write down on those cards and hang on the Christmas tree on the way out. Okay, you can include your year-end prayers also. Next announcement. As we come to the end of the year, our hearts are full of gratitude and thanksgiving. Because at the beginning of 2022, it hasn't been easy for many. It was still pandemic. But now the Lord has seen us through. So with hearts full of gratitude, we want to gather together at the end of the year. At the watch night service, we want to give thanks to the Lord that He has seen us through. There are many lighters I know that have gone through difficult and challenging season this year, but the grace of God have carried you, isn't it? So on the 31st of December, at both center, at night, 10:30 p.m., we are going to gather to count down and welcome the new year. So come with your family. Come to honor the Lord. Come to worship the Lord. And come to give thanks to the Lord at our watch night service. Now let us prepare our hearts as we prepare ourselves to give our best in terms of tithe and offering to the Lord. Shall we pray? Dear Father God, as we come with grateful heart, we want to give our best because you, Lord, you love us. You send your Son, Jesus Christ, to give His life for us. So out of a grateful heart, God, we want to give a portion what you have blessed us. Lord, may you use what we have given as a seed for the extension of your kingdom and for your glory. In Jesus' name, amen. As the offering bag is passed around, those who wish to give online, you may go through the banking app and give by internet banking. You may do so now. God bless you.
Just as the Lord gave His only Son, Let's give with a cheerful heart our tithes and our offerings unto Him.
Over the skies of Bethlehem appear a star, while angels sang to lonely shepherds. Three wise men seeking truth, they travel from afar, hoping to find a child from heaven. They're falling on their knees, they bow before the humble Prince of Peace. I'll bring an offering of worship to my King. No one on earth deserves the praises that I sing. Jesus, may you receive the honor that you're due. Oh Lord, bring an offering to you, and I'll bring an offering of worship to my King. No one on earth deserves the praises that I sing. Jesus, may you receive the honor that you're due.
Time to listen to what God has for us this weekend. Let us quieten our hearts and welcome Pastor Lawrence Khoo as he shares today's message.
Hallelujah! Praise the Lord! Have a blessed morning, everybody here in Woodlands and Tampines, and all joining us online. Wow, next week is Christmas already. So quickly. You know, in the two world wars, the country's head declared that they will not cease fire, just like what Russia did. It's going to do this round. He has declared that they will not cease fire during Christmas. But the soldiers didn't fight on Christmas Day. They share food, they play football, and we pray that this will happen between Russia and Ukraine again this time. Amen? Amen. On Christmas Day, precious souls are safe. But how do we see precious souls safe unless we invite? So please invite your relatives, your friends, your neighbors, your colleagues to next Sunday Christmas service, 10 a.m. It will be a bilingual service. Come in expectancy. Expect to see precious souls saved. All glory to God. Amen? Amen. Amen. I'm so excited this morning. The message is entitled Abound in Hope. This month we're having a hope series. It is the heart's desire of every pastor, your pastor, that in this season you will anchor in a hope. And that's the first message we have. And last week, we hear an evangelistic message on those that are lost is found back in hope. And today, we will be abound in hope. The message is about God's blessings. Are you all ears to receive God's blessings? Amen? Let me frame up what to expect in this sermon. Firstly, I'm going to begin with an introduction. A question: is hope passive or active? And then following the text, from the text itself, I bring you an acronym, GIA, that God of hope that you find in Romans chapter 15, verse 13. And then the word in believing, you receive a double bonus of peace and joy. And then abound in hope by the divine power of the Holy Spirit. Well, we have learned without the Holy Spirit, we won't be able to experience that power. So would you stand with me as we welcome the Holy Spirit and pray together? Would you say with me, Holy Spirit, we welcome you into our sanctuary and our homes. Holy Spirit, we welcome you. Illuminate our minds. Holy Spirit, we welcome you. Touch our hearts. Transform us and change us. In Jesus' name. Let us remain standing as we read scriptures together. Romans chapter 15, verse 13. Hear the word of God. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, so that by the power of the Holy Spirit, you may abound in hope. Amen. Please be seated. Let me begin with, is hope passive or active? That actually depends on whether you look at it from a worldview or do you look at it from the biblical view. From the worldview, since 1920s, when Disney produced the first Snow White, it messed up our minds. You know, even in that beautiful artistic animation, you see Snow White sitting by the well and she says, I'm wishing. And what is it that she's wishing? She's wishing for a handsome Prince Charming to come and rescue her. You know, Disney also has Beauty and the Beast, but she don't want any beasts. She wants her life partner to be a charming prince. And must be a prince. Why? Have palace, big house, a lot of money. Nah. Okay? And so you see, every little girl wants a prince. But then how many princes are there in the world? So you see how our minds are mixed up. The boys are not spared. The seven dwarfs were really cute. Dobby don't talk, he's charming. All of the seven dwarfs has their own characteristic that is so, so adorable. But none of us wants to be a dwarf. We want to be Prince Charming. My friends, you parallel that to our reality today. As we come to a year end, there are a lot of partying, champagne popping, beers, and celebration. But what is it that the people want? For the young ladies, you still want your Prince Charming, isn't it? And all of us are talking about getting out of the rat race, the poverty, because we think money and riches can buy us happiness. So when you parallel that, in the period of December, actually you see a lot of people intoxicated. They are drowning their sorrows, their pain, disappointment. Some of them are expecting some big returns from their investment, and it's gone. Some is waiting to meet the right, Mr. Right and Miss Right, and it just didn't turn out right. Some are waiting for a promotion. Some are waiting for great results. But in a sense, just hoping. And haven't we learned from Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs? They have many, many versions. The only hope that we can really have is anchored in Jesus Christ. That it is in Christ that is a solid rock. It is Christ that we can have our living hope. And so we look at a text to begin with, how do you abound in hope? God's character, as we hear the word itself, may the God of hope, God Himself, His very character, His very nature is hope. He is the source of all hope. He is the supplier of hope, if you like. He is a distributor of hope. He is the provider of hope, the source of hope. Yet, we are looking for hope in all the wrong places. We are looking for hope in so many places. As we party and receive gifts, we put on smile, but we still have this sorrow, and our smiles actually cover a mile apart from true joy and true happiness that we can only find in the God of hope. May the God of hope is His very nature and character. My friends, the book of Titus, chapter 1, verse 2 tells us, this God cannot lie. Therefore, the salvation promise of God that He resurrect Jesus from the dead and that salvation is for all is true. And many, many, many of God's promises is true. We need to get our hope in God. My friends, if this is the first time you're hearing the message on hope, then open your minds and open your heart that this God is a God of hope. Are you looking for this hope? For many of us who have accepted Jesus into our hearts, have we a long life's journey that is so tough that put our hope on something else, on someone else? My friends, I'm guilty of it. When I met some old aunties and uncles in church and they tell me, Pastor, I want to buy 4D. And they craft it so beautifully. I buy a little hope. Maika Siwang, which means I buy hope. And you know, I didn't want to dash their dreams, and that's my mistake for all these years. I said, okay, buy a bit, just a little hope. I am so wrong, my friends. This God of hope is the source of our hope. Why are we turning to something else? Haven't we read the papers, this woman who got 30,000 and two of her sons are fighting for it? Is that hope, winning such money? It was in the Straits Times. And so when the interviewer interviewed her, she said, my heart breaks. I'm not dead yet. My sons are fighting over 30,000. Friends, money will not give us hope. It is the God of hope that we should anchor in. And the whole book of Romans, it's the sixth book in the New Testament. It is the longest epistle that Apostle Paul has written. It is written to Jews and Gentiles. Gentiles, that's us. It is a message about salvation, that we now have an access to God's riches, grace, and hope. Are we tapping on it? We tap on the internet so much faster than we are tapping on this source, this God of hope. My friends, God that raised Jesus from the dead authenticates the gospel. He gives power to the gospel. And Jesus is our living hope. Amen. Where have we been putting our hope all this time? Where have we placed our hope? Believe. Practice. Put our hope in God. A God that keeps His promises. You know, my friends, we ought to be more passionate. When we know that God is a God of hope, you know what this hope does for us inside us? It gives us an inward satisfaction of the soul. Then we understand contentment. You see, many a times we will say, why Christians walk with their faces 7 inches touching the floor and dragging themselves to church? There are even jokes that preacher says that Christians are baptized in lemon juice. Let's cast out all this myth and nonsense. We ought to be anchored in this hope. And this hope itself is God. And having God, our lives will be so full of contentment. We start thanking God and be grateful for what we have and start trusting Him. When you look at your shoes and say, how I wish I can have a better brand of shoes, look again. There are many who have no feet. When you eat your wonton mee and chicken rice and say it's so ordinary, look again. There are people without food. So contentment actually brings us joy and peace. And listen to these beautiful words that's crafted. When you have the God of hope, it is an inward satisfaction of the soul. Receive that you want the satisfaction in God Almighty. And then we build inside us a well up delight in knowing Him. Do we know God? Often we talk about, you know God by reading the Bible. You know God in your quiet time, listening to sermons and praying. We know it. But friends, how many of us really wake up super early to do our quiet time? We know He's the source of hope. Why are we not running to that source of hope and still trying something else that has failed in all you know since the days of Adam? Why do we do that, my friends? Let's seek true joy in seeking the God of hope, and that we will have a desire of wanting God in believing. And the text go on that in believing, you will receive joy and peace. That's a double blessing. Joy and peace. And this joy is a different joy. This joy elates inside your soul. It's not just temporary happiness. And the peace, my friends, the peace ease your very soul. Last night, a very elderly lighter came to me and said, oh, Pastor, you know, I have some issues with my body and I cannot operate. I cannot go for an operation. I've been coming to the miracle service. And you know, all these years, Pastor, I now have so much joy. I'm so joyful. Oh, I say, hallelujah, praise the Lord. Please continue to come. Miracle service every first Saturday on site at the two centers. Second, third, and fourth Saturdays online. Watch TV, sister, watch TV. And she looked at me and said, Pastor, I know what's online. Wow! I said, yes, you know what's online. So, see, even in her pain, she has a joy that comes out from the soul. She has peace that eased the mind, heart, and soul. Three stories from the Bible. When in believing, in trust, such joy and peace is so prevalent. The first one, you remember the synagogue leader, that means the church leader, daughter died. And he went out to Jesus and said, Jesus, Lord, if only you put your hand on my daughter, she will live. And we know Matthew chapter 9, verse 18 to 19. Jesus placed his hand on the daughter and his daughter lived. Parents, you know how that feels, right? Your peace eases the very soul of parents. Your joy is elevated from inside out. We know also the common story that we keep hearing in and hearing out in every miracle service, the woman with the bleeding issue. You see, when she's healed, see the joy and the peace that comes in trusting Jesus Christ, in believing God. Mark 11:24. Believe that you have received. Believe that you have received. And you hear of that testimony just the first Saturday of this month. This sister came up and said, Pastor, I have some skin disease and I was completely healed. I have lumps on my breast. I took out two. The third operation, I said, no more doctors. I'm coming to the miracle service. And God healed. And this couple is very much late in their age, and this is difficult to have a baby. Together with a cell group, they keep praying for her. She conceived. But she wants to emphasize that the way she conceived the baby is that she experienced peace. Her word is peace. And throughout the pregnancy, it's peace. And so I keep going back to my cell group and tell them, please pray for peace. And the delivery was also so smooth, she named her child Joy. So you see, the God of hope, in believing, in trusting in Him, gives peace and joy. Another insight that she gives is, please join cell group. Cell group prays together, stays together, encourage and edify, and we remind each other to trust God and be given that double bonus. In believing, we receive joy and peace. In believing, the joy that elates the soul is not just happiness. Like I mentioned to you, many are in pain and in sorrow in these times. They are covering up their sorrows and their pain. Their smile, as I say so clearly, that is a mile away from true joy and happiness. Even true joy and happiness is found in God. Do you believe? Start taking action in your life. You believe in God's promises. My friends, do we know God's promises if we don't read the Bible? How do we know God's promises if we are not spending time in quiet time? Actually, I want to change quiet time to call quality time. Sometimes it gets way too quiet, isn't it? Believe in the Word of God, receive the Word of God, and have a quality time with God Almighty. He is the God of hope. And in believing, in trusting Him, joy and peace is yours. Isn't that what we are looking for? Are we not looking for joy, actually? When even in the fairy tale story that I tell you of Snow White, isn't she looking for true joy? Isn't she looking for true peace and the hope that's everlasting after everlasting? There is no hope that is everlasting on this earth, only in God. And the peace that is the soul. So this is the results of trusting God. When we trust God in joy and in peace, we are resting. We are resting in God even when we go through troubled times, difficult times, times of distress. My friends, listen to this closely. Christians' blessedness is that we are able to enjoy God's gift even in times of pain and sorrow. So this trust, this joy and peace is Christians' blessedness. Then the gift, God's gift, is unlimited. God's gift of this hope, peace, and this joy is limitless. Pastor, I want that. How do I get it in a limitless way? My friends, that's up to you. How much of your faith, how much you want to open yourself to receive the capacity to receive more and more and more from God, my friends, is truly up to you. His grace, His gifts is limitless. Are you limiting God? Would you open your hearts and receive Him and trust Him? And then it is your faith that you can receive this gift in a limitless way. In God, truly can we put our trust. Trust Him and Him alone. And the verse also says that by the power of the Holy Spirit, we will abound in hope. That hope is overflowing, and it's by the power of the Holy Spirit. It's a great divine. To be abounding in hope is not by human strength, not by any other source, but by the power of the Holy Spirit. And we have been taught and we've been praying, always welcome the Holy Spirit, because the power is in the Holy Spirit. We, as your pastors, have always practiced these five I's to you. First, the I is to impart and to instruct, to influence you, to impact you, and also to help you to be inspired, to love God more, to want Him more, and to have this inward satisfaction of God, of hope, to have joy that is so lifted up inside us, and the peace that is our very souls. Let me share with you some of this, a personal testimony, that by knowing this God of hope, by believing and trusting this God of hope, the blessings is unlimited. Then you will truly abound in hope. When my son was a little boy, 4 or 5 years old, he caught this fever, they call it scarlet fever. His cheeks are rosy red throughout the 7 days. The temperature is between 39.5 to 41. It is scary. It torments the parents. And so the doctor told me that by the 10th day, if the scarlet fever don't go away, he will have to be hospitalized. And then they will take all the blood tests and suspecting that it's going to be a Japanese fever. So on the 10th day, he was still feverish. I decided not to coop him at home anymore. I decided to carry him out because he wasn't eating so well. I carried him out. I brought him to West Coast Park. And I hoped that McDonald's will do the trick. So I prayed for him and then I brought him to McDonald's. He started eating. And his appetite grew. And suddenly became more bubbly. And so we cast out all the fever in Jesus' name. And he was completely healed. As we walked out of McDonald's, we met the late President Nadan. He was having an event there. He stopped by and looked at my son and made his day. And he said, "Hello, young man." And my son replied to him, "Hello, Mr. President." And so the late President Nadan said, "How did you know?" He says, "My kindergarten has your photo." He said, "Oh, how do I look?" And my boy went, the same. And so he said, "Can I take a photo with you?" The crew had all their bags, all their cameras zipped up. They had to unpack everything to take a photo with the late President Nadan and my son. It is the very soul of parents, right? You know how agonizing it is when you see a child in such pain and there's nothing that you can do. For 10 consecutive days, rosy cheeks that is from a fever, lowest point 39.5, and it goes up anytime. How traumatic that is. You see, even the best doctors, the medicine, didn't work. But trusting Jesus and the ease that He gives our soul. Even for myself, somebody asked me yesterday, a lighter was speaking to me, he said, "Pastor, it's easy for you. You know, you've got good looks, you speak so naturally, it's so easy for you." And I look at him, I said, "It has never been like that all the time. At the age of 9, I almost drowned in Sentosa. In my late 20s, I almost got into a car crash at Tanjong Katong Crossroad. A few years back, in Dallas, I was electrocuted. And then just a few months, 4 years ago, before coming to Lighthouse Evangelism, there was a little accident at the lobby of Malacca. I was thrown to the wall, my head hit the wall, bang! The whole hall, the lobby can hear that loud bang that's from my head onto the wall. And I went straight down, twisting my neck, brrrak! You can actually hear it. And I sat on the carpet. Many people came to me. The first thing I said is, "Don't touch me!" You know how much pain and agony it was. But interestingly, you know what I said? I said that it's my call to come to Lighthouse Evangelism. I told Pastor Pacer, "Can I take a short break, enjoy a sabbatical, then come back and serve in the following year?" That, to me, was a loud message. It's, "Lawrence, you may not have the following year. You almost died today." And I came back home, drive 3 hours, and said, "Pastor Pacer, I'm called to Lighthouse, and here I am serving you as your pastor. Why am I always so passionate? I'm always seeing life that God may take me away. I may die tomorrow, or I may be taken away somewhere else." But you see, this God of hope, when we understand hope, joy, and peace in such a way, you cannot not have this passion. You cannot not have this inward satisfaction in your soul that God is the God of hope. And that when you believe in Him, you trust in Him, He gives you peace and joy. That in all the situation and circumstance that is not easy, you will still have the joy of the Lord. Amen? Amen. Now let's go into application. Every time you ask me for an acronym, I always go down on my knees and crack my head and get you an acronym. And this acronym cannot be just something that you pluck out from the air. It must be from the Word of God. So you see, the GIA is from Romans chapter 15, verse 13. The God of hope, G. In believing, I. And abound in hope. The G-I-A. God is in action. Look around you. God is in action in your lives, in the lives of your children and your grandchildren, in the lives of your friends. God is already in action. Christmas Day, God has given His Son, Jesus Christ. A joy to the world. A star is born. God is in action. The book of Romans is about salvation for all humanity. God is in action. Are you in action? You trust this God. How much are you interacting with Him? How intimate are you with God Almighty? How are you abiding in Him that He's abiding in you? My friends, God of hope. That's His name, His character, His nature. He's the source. He's the supplier. Keep getting your supplies from this God of hope. every morning in your prayers and in your quality time, every evening before you sleep, speak to Him, walk with Him, hear Him. And in your meals, say grace, give thanks, and be filled with such great gratitude, because He's a God that keeps His promises. He's a God that cannot lie. And it's recorded for us in Titus. So the thing is, what about you? And I've given you the second application, NATO no more. What is NATO? Everybody knows, right? No action, talk only. We know it so well because it's become our way of life. My friends, NATO no more. From now in December 2022 to 2023, let's begin with a new one. NATO now has changed its code name. NATO is now action, take over. Now action, talk is over. Start believing, start living. Tonight, start your quiet quality time. Don't wait till tomorrow, tonight. And later when you go for lunch and have a meal with your family, have Christian fellowship where you talk about God, you talk about a message, you talk about the goodness of God and what God has done in your lives. NATO no more, my friends. Now action, take over by the power of the Holy Spirit. Pastor, I cannot. A leopard never changes its spot. True, with human strength, it can never be done. But with this God of hope, blemishes will vanish. The leopard spots will disappear. With God in the vessel, we can smile at the storm. Amen? Amen. So, NATO no more. And then truly, we can all sing Jesus Christ, my living hope. Would you take a moment to ponder? Is Jesus Christ your living hope? It's not a dead hope, it's a living hope. Along the way in life, where have you placed your hope? In job securities? In your saving accounts? In people? In your loved ones? Where have you placed your hope? Would you go home to even write it down? Where did you put your hope in this journey that you have accepted Jesus as Lord and Savior? And after you have written it all down, would you take a red pen and strike it off? My living hope is in Jesus Christ. Amen. And again, I always want to reach out to those, if this is the first time you're hearing of this hope. This hope, Apostle Paul wrote, are for all Gentiles. That's us. And if you want this hope, this is the time. Wait no more. NATO no more. Come and receive this hope. So when you're ready, I want to pray for two groups of people. The first one is, you've not had this hope and you want this hope to come forward. Make your way to the front. Tampines, Woodlands, make your way to the front that you want this hope. The second prayer is for those who have been Christians for a while, but we have misplaced our hope. We want to align ourselves once again that our hope is in this God of hope. Would you stand with me as we sing this chorus? And for those of you who want the prayer, please come forward.
Praise the one who sets me free.
want to pray first for the group, the first group of people that you want to invite Jesus into your heart. Even those joining us online, you may just kneel where your home is. And I see also Tampines. Let us pray for the first group of people. And the first group of people, will you say this prayer after me? Dear God, I am a sinner. I have placed my hope somewhere else. I believe that Jesus is the Son of God. I want this hope. Come into my heart and be the Lord and Savior of my life. In Jesus' name, amen. Now let's pray for those who have been Christians for a while and along the way we got distracted. We're not so much on fire for God, and our hope seems to be a wish rather than a hope. We want to correct that. I know you sincerely are seeking God. Would you open your hearts and plead to God Almighty? Let us pray. Our loving God, you're so patient with all of us. God, we met you and called you our Lord, our Savior at some point of our lives. Please forgive us as we then turn away and just do whatever we want, have our own way and place our hope in so many different places, in so many different ways, and in so many different people. Forgive us, oh God. Now we want to come back to you. And God, so we pray that may you, the God of hope, fill us with all joy, not a bit of joy, but all joy and all peace. And by the power of the Holy Spirit, we will abound in hope. Father, we plead and we ask, and we receive this, and Father, we can experience that warm sensation now from head to toe as we receive. We believe we have received and we abound in hope in Jesus Christ. And all God's people say, amen, amen. My friends, in all the stories that I tell you, as for me and my household, we will serve the Lord. And it's not that only I have that hope. It is not of human strength. But I abound in hope, because by the power of the Holy Spirit, we can abound in hope. And it's for all of us, all Gentiles who believe, which will now receive His blessings. Almighty God, loving Father, God of hope, fill us, O God, with all joy and peace. And now may the grace of God Almighty, the love of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and the wonderful fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you today and forevermore. And all God's people say, amen, amen. God bless you. Have a victorious week. Invite your friends next Sunday for our Christmas service.
Thank you for joining us online, and we hope you've been blessed. See you again next week.
praise you with my whole